everybody, welcome to the Stamperia YouTube Hub. I'm making a canvas today for you. I use some gray board, the A4. I really love this design, so I made it my background. I glued it all together with the mixed media glue. It's really nice to glue your paper to your canvas. You can also use it for rice paper to glue it or to give it a layer that it will be saved and sealed. Making my layout here a little bit, just looking where to put everything. Giving it all a big layer of black gesso and drying it really well. After that, another A4 chipboard, a gray board plate, and I used the gears in this one, glued them again with mixed media glue, and made a composition of it. Here I'm using the stencil Sir Vagabond the Cracks. I really love this one, and I'm using the modeling paste from Stamperia in there. It's really smooth, so it's really nice to make your own textures. Don't forget to put the sides on, because otherwise you have a really boring border. And after drying everything, of course, we need another layer of black gesso. Making my composition with lots of castings from different molds, I used the Sir Vagabond Clock and Stars, the Owl and Memories, the Lady Vagabond Soft Mold, the Belt and Fasteners, and the Flying Machine. And all of these castings I'm putting together with the soft heavy body gel, sorry, the gloss heavy body gel. I'm making my composition not by thinking too much, but just watching and putting in place. I love doing this because it's really, well, relaxing to do, and I love making a composition with these new molds. They are really, really beautiful. I love them because they can make a composition for your canvas or your book box. to glue the clock on the middle as my focal point. Now I'm using the Allegro paint, the white, just to dry brush to get my other colors to take a little bit much more color on my blue, which is the next color I'm gonna use. As you can see, here is the blue. First I was planning on just highlighting it, but then I changed my mind and made it just paint all the canvas with it, because I really liked it to be the color of my background. After I dried it, I really dry brushed it again, just to make sure that my other colors will have different pigments and different kind of shades when I'm putting them on my canvas. Here you see the Allegro orange. It is a really nice matte color, and I'm make it more liquid with a lot of water, so I can put it in places where I never come before because it's under the clock. And I spray some water on it when I put it on the canvas, so the colors will blend in together. And because it is a matte color, it really dries up really like a rust color. Really dry in between, so that the colors will become permanent and they do not blend into each other. As I mean that it doesn't become another color. Here I'm using the cookie from Allegro, and I will do the same with the shadow earth. Just going from a light color to a darker color, and because they all dry up really matte, it will give it a really rusty look. Here I'm using the aqua colors from Stamperia. They are more liquid, and I'm using the chestnut here. I spray again water over it because I want to blend in all the colors together, and it will not be one blob, but just smoothly going over the canvas. Here I'm using the Shadow Earth from Allegro. It's a really dark color, but if you dilute it with water, it will be very nice. And it will also, when it's dry, as I said, give it a matte look that is really nice and rusty. Here I'm using the wax from Stamperia, and I use the metallic pink, bronze, black, copper, and as at the last I'm using the white, just to give it a kind of a dry brush with what you normally do with gesso, but then with the white wax. I'm using a lot of different colors of wax together, so they blend in and will give it a beautiful, beautiful shine. It looks like I do nothing when you see it on my camera, but you will see the brightness later on in my pictures, because I do not know what was wrong with my camera when I recorded it, but it just didn't show me the colors I needed to show them. As I said before, I'm using the white wax. It is a matte kind of wax, so it will give me a kind of a dry brush. But it will be great because I want to highlight everything with orange. And because I didn't have an orange wax, I will use the Allegro orange and just make it into, well, my own kind of highlight wax. Just put it on my hand and get it everywhere I want it to shine. As you can see, it's not a problem to highlight with metallics or with matte wax paints, because it gives almost the same effect. And because these are matte, it will look like I put some rust on there. Here I'm using a lot of orange with a lot of water. I'm gonna make some splatters because I love to have splatters on my projects, because I think it gives it more depth. I hope you liked my video, and well, I hope you enjoy this up, and please jump over to my other former friends on this hub and give them a thumbs up, subscribe to our channels, and thank you again very much for watching to my channel.